Hello there. Listen, I've got an interesting video here. I want to conduct an experiment, and I'm inviting you to come along and join me in this experiment. In fact, do the experiment along with me, and maybe we can all learn something that it'll help each other, all of us, one or another. And it's to solve a problem which I have here at my QDH, and I'm sure that you have it at your QDH. Interested? Okay, come on, let's go. So the problem is, and I'm sure you have it too, is noise. Yep, I live in an urban area, and noise is a real problem. Let me just give you a little hint about what you can have a look and see what it's like. There's the noise spectrum for 40 meters at my QTH here. And as you see, it's a pretty solid wall of noise. I know there are signals in there because when I go down to the FT8 portion of the band, I can see those signals and I can hear them. So they're in there, but try and pull those out, try and pull signals out of this on CW end of the band or the single sideband end of the band, and we have a problem. And that's the problem which I want to address. Now, of course, with any problem like this, in a scientific experiment, we've got to first of all state the problem, but the problem's got to be a little bit more specific and it's got to have a bit of context as well. So here's the context. I live in an urban area, and this is a Google shot of my location here in one of the suburbs of Auckland. And as you can see, there's a lot of housing around me, and all that housing, of course, contributes to noise in one way or another, doesn't it? Now, the noise which I'm after trying to chase is the noise floor. Nothing. There's no specific noise. It's like buzzers or motor noise or that sort of stuff, or any one particular noise. If there was, I could get out a direction finding loop, we could go find it and so on. No, it's the noise floor which I'm trying to address. Now let's come in there for a closer shot onto my property. And there's my property, and I've hemmed it in blue there. That blue line will become significant in a little while, as will that red line that goes across the driveway there. Just take note of those. So that's our problem stated. Now, as we know, in any good scientific experiment, we also need to go and we have to have an aim in the experiment. And our aim now is to reduce the noise. Well, that's a simplistic answer, and that's a simplistic aim, but it's a little bit more than that. What I really want to do is to increase the signal to noise ratio. Now, we could do that by just simply, here's our noise and our present situation, our signal, sorry, there. And our present situations, our noise is encroaching on the signal. And so the signal to noise ratio is very poor indeed. We could improve that simply by, again, there's our signal. We could get the noise down here by constructing a very large antenna with multiple elements and multiple array antenna. However, we got to have our problem in mind. We're in an urban lot. I can't actually do this. I can't put up a 200-foot tower with multiple elements and multiple beams to achieve this. In other words, what we're achieving here is we're raising the signal level. We will raise the floor noise a little bit, but we raise the signal level greater than the noise level, so we get a good signal to noise ratio. Our problem is that here's our signal. We want to similarly reduce the noise. We're looking at this area here, get a good signal to noise ratio. But how are we going to achieve this? We have to achieve it by some other means, and this is by reducing the noise rather than increasing the signal, so to speak. That's our aim fairly well.
Okay, again, in true scientific fashion, we're going to need some equipment. Let me put myself up there so we can talk about it as well. The equipment needs to be simple. In fact, I just want it to be wire. A few insulators, perhaps, little bits and pieces, but nothing expensive at all, just a simple wire. And I think we can all rustle up a bit of wire to conduct our experiment with. You'll need a reasonable amount of wire, because what I really want to do is go right around the property like I have here in this blue line. So that blue line there goes right around the perimeter of my property. And the wire is actually held off the fence right along that, right around the property, except for two little areas there that you'll see that are in red. If you look carefully, there's one towards one area, small area towards the top of the shot there. And then there's a red area across the driveway. And that's where the wire actually goes under the ground. Top section there goes under the ground to where a pathway is. And of course at the bottom there, it goes under the ground, under the driveway. Let's go and have a look a little closer, shall we, at the way in which I've constructed this wire right around that perimeter. And I start off this ground loop using the base of a DX Commander. I haven't got this connected up in its normal configuration at the moment, just using the base plate so that I can connect into my radial system, and also using the driven plate so I can convenient way of connecting a PL259 into the system. And you can see that there's a small black wire coming up here onto the back of the trellis work. I actually have this black wire going right around the trellis work. You can see it's in behind the passion fruit vine there. At this stage, it makes an excursion down to the ground through this drain pipe across the pathway up onto the fence line, actually. Here you can see this wire is only 30 centimetres, about a foot off the ground. Every so often I have some little insulators, and we'll talk about those shortly. And so it continues on around the fence line in behind my hedge. There's another wooden fence behind this hedge, and it continues on in this fashion right around the perimeter of the section. I have the wire held off from the fence line every 2-3 meters, I guess, with one of these little plastic insulators, as found in electric fence work. And that just holds the wire off a little bit from the fence. Just a convenient way of holding the wire, really. The wire could actually be stapled directly to the fence line, no trouble.
Again, in true scientific fashion, the next thing in any scientific experiment, of course, is the method. We've covered the aim, we've gone through the equipment that are necessary. Now we need to know a method. So back to our board here. The method, we're going to actually run a wire right around the perimeter of the property, around the property, as we showed in that previous slide here, right here. So we're going to run a wire right around the property like that. And we're going to have that wire about 30 centimeters, 1 foot, above the ground. Above the ground, all around the, right around the property. There'll be, of course, there is a couple of places there where I have gone under the ground, and that's not going to cause us a problem at all, I assure you. What else do we need to know about the method? I've used insulated wire, and I have got little standoffs
to stand the wire off from the fence itself. And we'll cover that in a little bit. Well, that's our method. Okay, so here we have 40 meters, probably my favorite band on CW. I'm trying to find some SATA guys here on 7032. This is on my regular dipole. And you can see how noisy it is. Let's switch over to the loop and see what happens. There's a very faint CW signal there, but it's readable. Yeah, it's in the middle of a contest of some sort. Switch back to the dipole. Just noise, no signal there at all. Oh, if I listen very, very carefully, I can hear a scratch of a CW signal there, but not much. Switch back to the loop again. Oh, there you go. Still noisy, but a very faint signal. I could actually pull that out, I guess. And back to the dipole once more. Yep, nothing there. Oh, I think that's pretty good, isn't it? Very conclusive, really.
Wow. Wow. Well, now that's working astoundingly well, isn't it? I'm actually getting, I can hear the signals. Sure, there's no movement on the S meter at all. You can't see it, but I can hear the signals. So Q5, I can actually copy those signals now simply by using that very close to the ground loop antenna. For the interest of full disclosure, the few things I've done, I have enhanced the audio a little bit through my sound card. I can tweak the audio a little bit and enhance things and pull it up a little bit more. But the big thing is, I've actually got some signal I can work with now. And that's the whole secret. This is great. There is a sequel to this. We can take it a little bit further. I can actually boost those signals even more by putting in a small preamp into that loop. And that will be the subject of another video coming up very soon. So, what great results. Here we go. We can hear the signals now. There's no S reading, as we said. The copy is Q5. And that's the important part. We can actually copy these signals, and that's brilliant. Now, I would like to see what results you get. Grab a lump of wire, sling it out around the property. It doesn't have to be, as you've seen, it doesn't have to be anything flash at all. Get the loop as big as you possibly can and see what happens. There are a few other things we can do to enhance this a little bit. We can use preamplifiers. We can also use a balancing balance in there, a 9-to-1 balun that might actually help a little bit. But just do the wire system at the moment. Have a close listen, see if there's any perceptible difference between, now remember it's the signal to the noise ratio that we're after. See if that noise has dropped away a little bit, see if the signal is enhanced a little bit with your experiment. And put the results down in the comments below, would you? Love to hear from you. Now listen, for the ultimate antenna of low noise antenna, the real ultimate, you really need to go and have a look at this video up here now.